Mr. District Attorney, champion of the people, defender of truth, guardian of our fundamental rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Of charity never began.
Well, the wind's chilly, John. Should we go inside with the others?
Not yet, Molly. Read me that last part again.
My goodness, I'll have the newspaper worn out. You mean where it tells about us?
Please, I could read it myself, but my glasses...
Of course, John. Well, first it tells about how Dr. Harold founded Maple Lodge here, you know, for older people.
Oh, he was a wonderful man, Molly.
I know. Then it goes on to tell about his death.
And Mr. Fay.
Yes, that part's right here. Attorneys said later today that because Dr. Dennis left no will, Maple Lodge becomes the property of his nephew, Gerald Fay of Chicago.
He's not even a doctor?
It doesn't say, John, just that he announced plans to continue the lodge as before.
Does it mention this woman he brought with him?
Miss Mills? No, it doesn't.
Mrs. Benson says she's pretty.
Well, I wouldn't say pretty exactly, John. If she's a good nurse, that's all I ask.
Oh, Molly Fulton, at your age.
What, John? Now, I don't see that's funny, John Colby. Tell me.
You aren't afraid I'd caught her, are you, Molly?
Mills? You won't ever say. John, someone's coming. Yes?
Aren't you supposed to be in your room?
What? Oh, Miss Mills.
In our rooms, Miss Mills? But we were waiting here on the porch.
Oh, for lunch, he means. Today's Wednesday. We'll have corn fritters this noon, you know, and John just loves them.
Apparently you didn't hear me, Mrs. Fulton. Mr. Fay says you're to stay in your rooms.
Miss Fulton, and I certainly don't see...
No one's asking you to see anything. Now, will you get off the porch, both of you?
Molly.
I don't want to have to tell you again. And never mind about lunch. It'll be late.
Never.
She isn't very pretty, is she, Molly?
No, John, she isn't. Now I wonder about Mr. Fay.
Mr. Fay, Chief. Go right in, please.
Thank you, Miss Miller, isn't it?
That's right.
Yeah, thanks, honey. Mr. District Attorney?
Yes, come in, Mr. Fay. I see you've met Miss Miller.
We spoke outside, Chief.
Oh, yes. And this is Mr. Harrington.
Hi, how do you do?
Now, sit down, won't you? Sorry to keep you waiting.
Oh, not at all. I'll get right on to business, D.A.
Yes.
I suppose you know about Maple Lodge, the old folks' home?
That's right, Mr. Harrington. Belonged to my uncle, Dr. Harold Dennis.
Well, yes, I had the pleasure of meeting your uncle several times, Mr. Fay. We were all sorry to hear of his death.
The whole community was. Everyone says Maple Lodge was such a fine place.
Oh, not was, Miss Miller. Is. And if Jerry Fay has anything to say about it, it's going to be even better.
Yeah, the paper said something about you running it.
Yeah, I came the minute I heard, Harrington. Just dropped everything in Chicago and came on. I owe that much to Uncle Harold's memory.
Yeah. You're a doctor, are you?
No, sir. I'm not. D.A., Maple Lodge needs your help. I don't mind saying, after I sized up the situation out there, I came right to you.
Help about what?
Well, it's a good home, sure, but it needs support, D.A. Public interest. Publicity, if you want to put it that way.
You mean money?
In a way, yes.
In other words, Mr. Fay, you want to raise funds. Is that it?
Can you think of a worthier institution, D.A.?
Well, Maple Lodge has a right to accept charity, of course. As I recall, the guests pay only a moderate fee to live there.
Yes, that's right. Mm-hmm. But with outside help, a few donations here and there, why, I can make the place a paradise.
Yeah, sure.
So, what am I going to do? Get ink, Harrington, ink. That's an old newspaper phrase, means publicity.
Yeah, I know.
Will you help, Mr. D.A.? A speech from you, a banquet or a dedication, something like that, that'd be a great start.
Oh, yes, well, this isn't a publicity office, Mr. Fay. You know that. And still...
We've never refused our help where we think it's needed.
Well, that's fine. Then I can count on you. Oh, and say, you come out and get to know our people, will you? You too, Miss Miller? I'm telling you, they'll tear your heart out.
Oh?
Yes. Well, you're a busy man, D.A., so am I. You'll hear from me soon.
Yes, thank you for coming in, Mr.
Oh, thank you. Don't bother, Miss Miller. I can find the door. Thank you again.
So long, Fay.
Goodbye, Mr. Fay.
Didn't you say something, Harrington?
Well, I don't get it, Chief.
Seems clear enough, I suppose. A place like Maple Lodge can always use donations.
Yeah, but that guy here... Well, everything he said stacks up okay, but...
You ask me, he makes me creep.
Exactly, Miss Miller. Me too.
Yes, I know what you mean. He seems to have the best of intentions, but still... Something about him makes me wonder.
Hey, Karen, did you see the eagle? They put that feature story on page 3.
Great. You want a drink, Jerry?
Now, lay off, I told you. I told you that'd make the papers, kid.
John and Molly. Loving the old folks home.
Well, one of your lovebirds is cooling his heels outside.
What, up here in the office?
The old man, John. I told him to just sit and wait.
Now, what's he want now?
How should I know? He complains all the time. They all do.
Any more trouble in the dining room?
Sure, they were yelling about the mashed potatoes. Where'd you learn that trick with the air hose?
Honey, that's as old as the hills. You shoot air into a pot of mashed potatoes, you end up with a mountain of them.
That's what they taste like.
Well, so what? Hey, did I tell you I saw the DA?
4 times. So he's going to make a speech. So what?
All right, look, I know this ain't a picnic, but will you stop griping?
I don't like institutions. They remind me of... places.
Well, you like dough, don't you? Give me 6 months with this layout and we can retire.
In 6 months, you'll have a mutiny. They're all yelling, I tell you. Take that old fool outside.
They can be handled. Send them in.
They ought to be in straitjackets, if you ask me.
Now, take it easy.
All right, come on. You, I mean.
I've been waiting a long time, Miss Mills.
Have you got anything better to do?
Well, what's on your mind, John? I'm busy this morning.
When Dr. Harold had this office, we didn't have to walk up the stairs.
My uncle is dead. We can't have you people using the elevator, John. You might get hurt.
Is that what you wanted, to holler about the elevator?
I don't want to holler about anything, Miss Mills. It's about the paper this morning.
The paper?
There's a story about Miss Fulton and me, Mr. Fay. Everyone's talking about it.
Oh?
It seems to say that we're... in love, I think, is the wedding.
Does it?
Now, don't you go ignoring him, Mr. Fay. We won't stand for it.
You won't what?
I didn't come up here to argue, Miss Mills. We found out what good that does.
Now, just a minute, old time.
No, Mr. Fay, you listen to me. A story like that is cheap and insulting, both to Miss Fulton and to me.
Well, I'll...
handle this, Karen. Go back to your room, John.
I will. Only let this be a warning to you, my boy. We won't stand for it. None of us here. We won't stand for a lot of things.
Mr. Fay said to go to your room.
Both of you. You think we're all in helpless? Well, we're not. You go too far, you'll see. You hear me? You'll see.
Well, what do you know? The old ghost slammed the door on you.
You know something, Karen? That old goat can go too far.
Well, all right, Mr. Fay. If it was a mistake, I'm sure you'll call the papers and correct it. No, no trouble. All right, and thanks.
What'd he say, Chief?
Well, he saw the papers, Harrington. He admits that much, at least.
Saw them?
Yes.
My golly, it's in every paper in town. Look at this headline here. Movie star's mother, welcome to old folks' home.
Yeah, how do you explain it, Chief?
Why, he says he merely called the newspapers and said she'd be welcomed at a reception out there.
He what?
Yes, that's his explanation, Miss Miller. He meant she'd attend a party, and the papers took it to mean that she was going to live there.
Oh, brother. Now I've heard them all.
Yes, it impresses me as questionable, to say the least. However, he promised to call the papers and correct the matter.
Well, he'd better.
You know, Chief, I got a thought about Mr. Fay.
Yes. I've had quite a few myself in the last week or so.
Well, it's nothing I can put my finger on, understand? But
All these newspaper stories, all this high-powered publicity.
Well, I think it's disgusting. And another thing, all those stories about Molly and John, you know, the two old people in love. That's so cheap.
Yeah. Well, go on, Hank.
Well, it's just a thought, Chief. Mm-hmm. Like Miss Miller says, he operates kind of cheap.
I'll say so.
So how'd it be if I call a few of the boys in Chicago and ask some questions? You know, just to see who he really is.
I got news for you, Jerry. He's waiting outside again.
John?
Hmm.
I kind of expected it. Molly with him?
She can't climb the stairs.
You know what to do if things get rough.
How rough can they get?
Never mind. That story made every paper in the state. And what a picture.
Look, Jerry, it's your show. Way back in Chicago, I just came along for the ride.
We're doing okay, baby. Another week of build-up, I'll start yelling for donations.
But
touch off the campaign with the DA himself making a speech.
Look, will you let me on? You're going overboard, kid.
What's that supposed to mean?
Just what I said. That break about the stars, Mutt, that wasn't so good.
All right, so we apologize. Maple Lodge still made the papers, didn't it?
Okay, okay, let that one ride. But if I were you, I'd lay off John and Molly. The old man will blow his top.
We're ready for that one, aren't we?
Well?
I said, aren't we?
I'll let him in. You can come in now.
Good morning, John.
Mr. Fay.
Sit down, won't you?
What I have to say, I can do standing up. I've written a letter, Mr. Fay. Molly made three copies.
A letter to who?
Let John finish, Miss Mills.
To the newspapers. I have them right here. Here you see?
Well, I'll be glad to look at them, John. You know that.
I'll keep them, Mr. Fay. Yes, and I'll see that they're mailed, too.
Well, what do they say, John? We'd be interested.
I should think you would be. They're about the lodge, Miss Mills. The bad food. The way we have to stay in our rooms. How you got rid of the radio. Everything.
Oh?
And what's more, we've told the papers the truth about these cheap publicity stories.
I see. Oh, Miss Mills, you have something to attend to outside, I believe?
Now, Mr. Fay?
Yes, I think so. We'll excuse you. Run along.
Whatever you say.
All right, John. Let's get at it. You're going to mail those, are you?
I am. Unless things change, sir, and change mighty fast.
I see.
You seem to forget we have rights here. All of us. We paid when we came. Our life savings, some of us.
I go on.
That was the understanding with Dr. Harold. We paid, then in return we're to be cared for.
Well, I think you're just excited, John. Folks don't like the food. Now, we'll fix that immediately.
No, it isn't only the food.
All right, everything, then. We'll get new radios. A lot of them.
And the newspaper stories?
About you and Molly? Not another one, John. After all, I didn't realize you'd object. It was just a... I'll call it a human interest angle.
We object strenuously.
Then they'll stop. Now, anything else?
Why, no. No, I think that's all. I must say, this surprises me.
Why? Because I want to do the right thing? Oh, come, John, give me a chance. I want you people to be happy. Just takes time for me to learn, that's all.
You know, I believe you mean that, Mr. Fay. I'll tell the others.
Why, of course I mean it. Now, you go back downstairs and you forget all about it. Everything's going to be just fine.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Fay. I will. Thank you.
Now, it's dark here at this landing. I must put in a light.
What? Oh, yes, yes. Thank you again, sir. I'll tell the... Oh! Oh!
Is that you down there, Miss Mills? Hurry, will you? The old man fell down the stairs. I'm certain. certainly sorry you picked a day like this to visit us, D.A.
Yes, it happened this morning, you say, Mr. Fay?
Yes, that's right. Mm. The poor man wanted to see me, and since the elevator's out of order, he had to use the stairs.
What's the matter with the elevator?
I don't know, Mr. Harrington. I've got a man coming this afternoon.
Oh, what about Molly? She must feel terrible.
She does, Miss Miller. John's death was a terrible blow to all of us.
Well, we won't bother her at a time like this.
We're going to have a service tomorrow, D.A. It would mean a lot if you could make it.
That's what I'll try, Mr. Fay. Will you check my calendar when we get back, Miss Miller?
I will, Chief.
Well, I'll be glad to show you around now, D.A. No, as I say, it's a sad day here at the lodge.
No, no, we won't stay. You ready, Miss Miller?
Yes, I'll get to do it.
Come again, won't you? Tomorrow, if you can.
No, we'll be seeing you, Fay.
Yes, goodbye.
Poor old man. I almost feel as though I'd known him.
So do I. You know, I...
What happened, Miss Miller?
Well, I'm all right. I think.
Well, let me help you. Sure, you're all right?
All right, sure.
Understand?
Sure. Honestly, Chief, I just slipped.
I'll say you did. Say, look at your sleeve.
What? Oh, no. My new coat, too.
Yes, you must have torn it on the tread.
Yeah.
Say, I don't like this, Harrington. Stairs like these in a home for the aged. I don't like it at all.
I shouldn't have to tell you, Molly. Don't come into this office without knocking, ever.
I'll take her back to her room. You just keep your hands to yourself, Miss Mills. And as for coming up here, you just try and stop me.
Now, now, now. You're upset, Molly. We all are. John's death is a tragedy.
Listen to me, young man. I may be old, but I'm not a fool. There's something going on here.
What do you mean by that?
I mean I'm leaving, for one thing. And I'm going to find somebody on the outside who'll listen to me.
How can you leave, Molly? Didn't you give my uncle your savings when you came?
Mr. Fay is right, Molly. You'd be a public charge.
Would I?
It may interest you to know John gave me his bonds, young lady. War bonds, good as gold.
Oh?
I think you'd better come back to your room, Molly. Now, get your hands off me. You don't frighten me.
No one wants to frighten anybody, Molly.
I know that. You can't afford another accident, can you?
What?
You heard me. You think we don't know the district attorney was here?
That's none of your business.
No, well, it's going to be, young man, and don't think it isn't.
You come with me, Jerry. Go.
Put her in the room, Karen.
Come on.
And when you get her, they'll lock the door.
Well, this'll help, Chief.
Yes?
I got the reports from Chicago.
On Jerry Fay Harrington?
Himself. He sure ain't had much practice taking care of old people, Chief.
Oh?
Now, as far as the boys can figure, he used to sell slot machines.
What?
That's right. He's been picked up 4 or 5 times on suspicion. Served a year once for assault.
Well, how in the world did Dr. Nennis get a nephew like that?
Well, that's here, too. Apparently, the old man never even laid eyes on him.
Oh, I remember that when he died. The papers mentioned it.
Yeah. Well, the fact remains he's got his hands on Maple Lodge.
Yeah, some place for old folks, all right. Stairs like that. Oh, how's your arm, Miss Miller?
Oh, I'm all right, Harrington. I just bruised it a bit when I tore my coat.
You went back and examined those stairs, Harrington?
That's like you said, the Chief.
Yes.
They're steep, but they're sound. No building inspector would condemn them.
How about the elevator?
Well, I fixed it. At least it was running this afternoon.
Oh, Harrington, did you see Molly?
No, I didn't, but I asked about her. That dame said she was resting. I guess the old man's death must have hit her pretty hard.
Oh, sure.
Yes, it hit me hard, too. There's nothing definite to go on, but still...
Yes, Chief?
Well, there's something wrong out there, and I want to know what it is.
Now, look, Jerry, either you go with me or I'm clearing out alone. I can go back to that dice table in Chicago, you know.
Will you calm down? There's no need to blow your top.
How is it? With the D.A. here this morning and that Harrington jerk back again this afternoon?
Well, so what? Did they find anything?
He asked for Molly, didn't he? You can't keep her locked up forever, you know.
I can take care of her.
How? Another accident?
Maybe.
Oh, you're crazy, Jerry. We're not even sure the D.A. buys the first one.
All right, I'll think of something else.
What?
Oh. Look, I'm telling you, I've got this all set up now for a pitch. I've got enough publicity, we can get real dough. People go for charity stuff, baby. You know that.
Charity begins at home, Buster. I want to go back there.
Yes, and admit there was something phony. Don't be stupid. The thing now is to think.
Oh, great. Well, start thinking some. Start with old Molly, locked up in her room.
Idea, Chief.
Yes.
Let's go out there and tear that place apart.
But with what kind of a warrant, Harrington? We can make an inspection, that's true. And you know how much that would bring.
Well, if you do go, be careful of the stairs.
The stairs?
Oh, I was just kidding.
Yes, I know, Miss Miller. Only those stairs bother me, and they have ever since... Sam Miller.
Yes, Chief.
That coat you were wearing, the one you tore.
Oh, my green one.
Yes, is it here?
Why, yes, Chief. I was going to take it out and have it fixed.
May I see it, please?
Why, sure. It's in the closet here.
I don't follow you, Chief.
Well, it may be nothing, Harrington, but still, I have an idea.
Which is the room?
Molly, the last one on the right.
All right, come on. Got the rest of them safe?
No, they're all in their room. Jerry, wait.
Now what?
Well, you're just going to talk to her, aren't you?
What's the matter with you? You getting soft?
I just mean don't start anything rough, that's all. She gets hurt, you'll never explain it.
That depends on how bad she gets hurt. Now go on, open up. You got the keys?
Not here. Only watch it, will you? We're in deep enough right now.
Open the door.
Yes, who... Oh.
Mind if we come in, Molly? Shut the door, Karen.
What do you want?
Mr. Fay told you. We want to talk.
I'll talk all right. I've been locked in here like a prisoner.
Yes, well, that was a mistake, Molly, and we're sorry.
And John, that was a mistake, too?
What?
Don't play innocent with me, the two of you. I don't know what you're trying to do, but it's not right, and I'm going to the police.
I don't think you'd do that, Molly.
Wouldn't I? Oh, I thought this over, my young friend. You can't stop me if you tried.
Can't I?
There's no stairs here, Mr. Fay. Jerry.
I'll handle this, Karen. Now, you get something straight, Molly. Once and for all.
I think I have.
You're old. Not only that, people don't care about you.
That's not true.
Suppose you had a heart attack or something. Right here in this room, let's say.
Oh, don't you talk that way.
You think anybody would really care? It's another poor old woman, they say. They have to die sometime, you know.
Jerry.
Shut up. You see what I mean, Molly?
Don't come near me. I warn you.
I've had enough out of you, you old hag. All I have to do is hold my hand over your mouth.
Jerry, no.
Go. Go. Jerry, you fool. Let her go. Go. Jerry, go.
Darling old hag, you.
Jerry, look out.
One.
Yes, it's all right, Molly. Here, here on the
floor. All about her, Brophy.
There we
and
are.
And take this woman
let's
with you.
Go, everything's going to be all right.
Let's go.
Molly, you okay?
He won't hurt me, will he? He was trying to kill me.
No, he won't hurt you, Molly. Not where he's going. We want him for murder. All right, pick him up, Harrington, and let's go.
Again, same time, same station, when we again present Mr. District Attorney. This is the United States Armed Forces Radio Service.